Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Ecliptic Spiritualist channel. It is February the 27th. It is Thriving Thursday here, coming at this last Thursday of February. And wow, this second chapter is coming to an end of 2020. But we've got work to do, right? So let's get into today's Daily Fresh Tarot card reading. Now, we have got the Five of Swords. We've got the Five of Swords. And that's our card for the day. And we have, in reverse, and we have our Four of Wands here. And it is in reverse as well. Okay, so should you forgive the past, this tension? Yep. That's the title of the Divine, the Source, the Angels is given for this day, okay? And so there are areas here with this Five of Swords, all right? There are areas here of regret, unforgiveness. There's some blockages that are in play as well, you know? This includes like self-blame, also includes co-workers, partners. You truly want the relationships to be restored. So these are combinations of relationships. They can be various relationships. Keep in mind that this is a general reading. So if you need a direct reading about your own circumstances, always go on and schedule a private reading, okay? But this is a general reading. So it's telling us that we've got some challenges here, some regrets, some unforgiveness, there's some blockages in relationships, including self-blame, and co-workers, bosses, partners, lovers, and you do desire the relationships to be, restored. But as I clarify today with this Four of Wands, there is like a meltdown and a breakdown of communication to known. There's like an unknown. This leaves like you feeling uncertain, okay, because there's a breakdown and meltdown in communication. So it brings about some areas of uncertainty, all right? So as I was going through this with the Divine, the Source, and the Angels of Spirit, guys, I'm getting back to giving some tips about how to handle circumstances in this, all right? And the Divine was leading me in that today. So I always like to go, I always pull my cards before I come because I sit with the Divine for information and how to bring it properly and to mold it over. That's my style. Everybody has their own magical practice and how they sit and sup with the Divine, the Source, and the Creator, and a spirit guide. So anyway, how do we move to this past tension? How do we move past tension? Okay. So every relationship we have, you know, whether it is our kids, children, our partners, ex-partners, separation, some may be in separation with others, of love, bosses, parents, customer service, yes, has moments of tension and challenges. All right. So the big stuff is, you know, coping also with cheating spouses or partners, you know, how to work with co-workers. These are the big stuff. How to work with co-workers, bosses, or who may not share your values, you know, how you see things. Here are a few tips that I like to give to use for yourself and you not to pull the blame game either of why this is occurring, because now you place a blame on others and not us doing some self-examination, how to deal with, how to move past tension, okay? So we've got granting do-overs. You know, sometimes we have to grant do-overs in situations like stuff is going to happen. You know, it's going to happen. So with good people are going to make big, messy mistakes. You know, we all make messy mistakes. So, but sometimes the best way to get through an upset is to give the other individuals that we're dealing with benefit of the doubt, you know, to move on. You know, sometimes we have blow-ups, but perhaps you did with this person. You played a part as well. So nobody meant to cause issues. You know, we all have challenges. However, a do-over, granting do-overs, allow you to start again without rehashing situations without rehashing them, giving this freely out loud or quietly to yourself. Okay, so our second one is, you know, be quiet and listen. You know, be quiet and listen. This is a key element to moving past tension, because lots of times we want to be heard, but we have to learn to be quiet and listen so that you can actually hear. Okay, and sometimes we all have tendencies, some do, some don't, have tendency to overtalk everything. This is a continual work in progress with a lot of people, but you actually have to do a work in progress to shut down that area over talking. So you may want to just stop, just stop talking, you know, be able to listen. So many times in relationship squabbles are a product of miscommunication and misunderstanding. And this is what sometimes terminate relationships, because we're not able to hear or understand, or miscommunications, misguided, misunderstood. But you aren't going to clear those up without equal airtime. Everybody got the flow. Everybody's got to be able to talk. So when you spend time listening and without reacting with our body language, you'll gain more clarity, and this will help you to resolve things and be at a better peace. You know, not with the poor body language, rolling the eyes, being defensive because you don't want to listen. And lots of times when I am doing intuitive readings or doing spell work, and there's, or doing, you know, energy healing is a little different, but sometimes when you're doing spell work or you're doing intuitive consultations, I can tell with lots of clients as well, and working with family members and stuff, that's an area that people really struggle in, and that's an area that causes a lot of breakdown in relationships, miscommunication, not being able to be quiet and listen. Also, too, pause, breathe, and leave. Often we are triggered by events that sends us spiraling into bad behavior. With what? Reaction. So this, instead of being able to deal with the real issues, we have to mop it up from the drama, okay? So when you feel things start to escalate, take a deep breath. Respectfully announce that you are going to take a time out and will come back in about 5 or 10 minutes to talk over the issue. Don't storm off. Don't have a pity party, all these type of things. This is not time for slamming doors, acting out, but just take deep breaths and leave, you know, and also be mindful of the reaction, you know, having text wars back and forth, calling back and forth, you know, showing up in places and not allowing people their own private time to balance out things, not being reactive all the time. Also, some of us lack reaction. You know, we are stubborn to where we don't want to reach out to the other person and say, hey, how are you doing? How can we get back into communication again? You're not being stubborn and holding on to resentment, but being open to reach out to that other person and say, hey, I love you. How can we re-communicate together successfully? You know, can we sit down and have some coffee or tea, not being stubborn? Can we have real conversation and not texting, but having a connection spiritually with our voices? You know, we live in an age where everything is text fight, combination fight of texting, but not hearing and vibing from our spirit, which is hearing from our voice of passion. Okay. So also too, taking an outside point of view. You know, sometimes the best way to work through conflict is to approach the situation as an outsider. How would I respond looking on the outside in? Taking that outside approach, we'll be able to reason through it more appropriately. You know, if we take an outside point of view, just keeping it simple and acting as a third party, okay? Very important. And having patience is another way how to move past tension. Also, I'm going to add, and I'll keep this a little short, another area that it needs to be worked through with infusing our emotions is the type of language that we're using that is offensive. We have gotten into a society that everything is okay. You know, using, and I'm just going to say it, using profanity to express ourselves can be very degrading. I know that those words are very lucent today in the millennium, but is it really effective? You know, words hurt. Words hurt. So we have to be careful in that profane language that can be offensive, you know, and downgrading, because they do shatter glass. You know, words do hurt. You know, people, it's an old saying, sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt me. Yes, words do hurt. You know, so we need to bridle our tongue and reeling back that wheel of profane language, because it is offensive. You know, we've gotten to the point that even in daily business affairs, consumer affairs, that it's okay to use certain language, but it really is offensive. And some people don't realize it, they're saying these words in an area of consumership, but not realizing that it can be violating a person from their point of view, that language is offensive. So we do need to reel back or check ourselves in this kind of language, because it really is offensive to the ear, you know, whether we want to admit that or not, because we have adapted to it. And knowing that profane language is so cutting to the heart of a person, whether we want to accept it or not. That's from what comes from the Angel Spirit Guides today. So we do want to check that area, because we can use a more balanced language to express ourselves successfully without it being devaluing of a person, devaluing them with using, and then you say it so much that you're like, oh my God, I use this language with a person even doing business with them. It's something that we need to work on in our society. We really need to gauge that. So I am going to share, I don't want to be real long-winded, but that was something that the divine just wanted me to express. But today on this Thursday, as far as our astrological forecast, we have moving through the night tonight, squaring off with Jupiter in Capricorn. It's one that's not so harsh with the moon squaring with Mars, but here we can believe to wake up ready for freshness today. And so you'll feel more motivated and doing some things first and not hesitating. Okay. So it is a great energy that's coming in, that's fresh. So utilize that to, go through your to-do list, have a good strategy, but always do first things first and applying a life skill of self-balance and self-wellness for yourself today. So in saying that, don't forget to click that willy bell, ding dong ding, to make sure you're getting the fresh tarot card reading that comes on a daily basis. Don't forget that to believe and trust in yourself first always. Schedule your intuitive readings with us. Schedule your spell work. Schedule your energy healing with us so that you can be balanced and wellness and whole. We are bringing that to the website. We'll be able to offer that in distance healing and locally in the office here locally, which we do offer. As well, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe on Instagram, YouTube, and Twitter. We do have some videos coming up for studying our journaling series. Don't forget, next week will be the 1st of the February, the 1st of the month. So we will have our saint vigil coming in. So I will have the link. It is up now, so you can start purchasing it for $7.77. So you could be on our altar with bringing in our blessings and our blessings and our intentions for the beginning of March. And we're moving into a spring solstice equinox as well. So in fact, I love you for watching today. Don't forget to dig deep and trust in yourselves first always. I will see you next time. Bye-bye.